96% PhD applications get rejected. So unless your application makes it to the top 4%, it's going to the trash bin. But what if I told you the game has always been rigged? The people who are reading these applications and making these decisions about admissions are not robots, but humans. So the top 4% that make it to the acceptance list are not necessarily the ones with highest GPA or the most number of publications. What if I told you there is a way to play on human psychology and put your application on top? What's up everybody, Sadia Khaf here. I'm an electrical engineer doing PhD in machine learning, and on this channel, I help other students get into their dream engineering universities. So if you're a student and you're new to the channel, you might want to subscribe. Why do so many applications get rejected? Well, one obvious reason is that there are simply too many applications per position available, but there are some common reasons that I have noticed in my experience of reviewing PhD applications, and I want to share them with you. There are mainly two reasons that PhD applications get rejected. The most common reason being applying for the positions that are not relevant to your background. You simply don't have the relevant information about the position, you don't have the relevant background, you don't have the necessary skills for the PhD, you don't have the relevant education, your application is definitely going to get rejected. And the second most common reason I found was copy-pasting the applications. Remember, applying to 100 different applications with the same copy-paste application does not improve your chances of getting accepted for the PhD. So this copy-paste culture of applying for PhD positions is the second biggest reason so many PhD applications get rejected. So how can you make your application stand out in a pile of other PhD applications? I'm going to give you three secret tips that nobody else is telling you about to make your application stand out in a crowd. Tip number one, find connections. Don't underestimate the importance of having someone who can vouch for your work. So find your colleagues, your seniors, people you have worked with, your supervisors at work, anyone who has seen your work firsthand, and see if they have a PhD position available in their group or with their supervisor, because having a human speak for your experience, for your skills, your work is always much, much, much better than having a piece of paper speak for you. If you have a senior who is doing a PhD with a supervisor, and if they have a PhD position available in their group, ask them to refer you, because your friend can vouch for your skills, your projects firsthand, and that always speaks volumes about your skills rather than just your piece of paper application documents. Tip number two, be memorable. Imagine if you're on the selection committee and you're reading 150 applications for a robotics position, who will you remember? Someone with good grades, or someone who, as a kid, built a robot washing machine for doing laundry for the clothes of her dolls and later repurposed that robot washing machine into an air conditioner? That was me, by the way. I did that because I was always more interested in robots and electrical engineering and other stuff than dolls. And I have mentioned that story in a number of MS and PhD applications and scholarship applications because that makes me memorable compared to other candidates. It gives me an edge. Or imagine if you're applying for a library management position, for example, who will you remember? If your grandfather left you a library at the age 10 when he passed away and you were taking care of the library, now would be a good time to mention that story in your application, because that will make the human reading your application remember you. And if you can make the person reading your application remember you over 150 other applications, the position is most likely yours. Tip number three, highlight the muscle, hide the fat. What do I mean by that? I mean, make your application as concise as possible. If you're applying for a robotics position, you don't need to mention your experience as a babysitter somewhere 10 years ago. Make it as relevant as possible. Highlight the skills that are most relevant to the position you're applying. Hide everything else, because everything else is fat. You only need to highlight your muscle that is useful for that particular internship, position, PhD, MS, any kind of application that you're applying for, you always need to highlight your strong points. So highlight the experiences that are relevant to the positions and cut everything else that is not relevant to that particular position. And you don't need to make your applications very long. If the word limit is 5,000, you don't need to write 5,000 words to be able to be a good candidate. Write as concise and as short as possible. If you can tell a better story with 100 words than 5,000, you're valuing the time of the reader. And when you value their time, they will appreciate you for this. These were my three tips that have made me gain a lot of success in my academic career. My MS and PhD applications have never been rejected. Most of my scholarship applications have never been rejected. I have mostly got all the scholarships that I have ever applied to. So if these tips helped you, but if you need more help, you can always reach me out at academiccoaching.ml. I'll leave the link in the description as well. I help students with their application documents. I help them get into graduate school of their choices by reviewing their documents, reviewing their CVs, and helping them improve their documents, making it stand out. So if you need help, you can always reach me out at academiccoaching.ml. And if you've liked these tips and you're applying for any graduate scholarship right now, you might want to watch my other video at the end of this video, which shows you how to highlight your research potential in your CV with zero publications. See you next time.